After about 2 weeks of break, La Liga is finally back, and Barcelona must secure 3 points against Valladolid. Let's go ahead and break down everything you need to know before tomorrow's game. Let's get to it. Hello guys, welcome back to El Merengue Culé. It feels like forever since I've made a video, and it just feels so good to be back. And let me tell you right now, this next month is gonna be crazy, filled with Champions League, with defining La Liga games. So you're definitely gonna wanna stick around, but let's go ahead and kind of put into perspective where La Liga is currently at, where we left off, what has happened, because trust me, a lot has happened. So last time around in La Liga, we actually managed to beat Real Sociedad 6-1. Massive, massive victory for us. And that pretty much left us 4 points behind Atletico Madrid. And well, Real Madrid, currently right now, they are ahead of us, but they have played an extra game. So with that being said, Atletico Madrid just got done playing their game. And well, Sevilla managed to get 3 points off of them. This is absolutely massive, because it means La Liga is officially in our hands. With both Real Madrid and Atletico Madrid left for us to play, it is 100% in our hands to win this La Liga. And man, I think this is probably the first time that we get this feeling in this La Liga. All right guys, but now let's go ahead and break down some team news that's going around for both of us, Barcelona and as well as Valladolid. For starters, Sergio Roberto is actually fit to play in tomorrow's match. Now, personally, I don't think he'll play. I don't think that's the smartest of decisions. But hey, it's good news. Definitely, we want to stack up as much good news as possible. On the other side, for Valladolid, 5 players tested positive. And Orellana, who I probably would have made him my player to watch out for, got suspended. 5 players tested positive, and Orellana is suspended. So most likely, Oscar Plano is gonna have to replace him, but let's continue. Valladolid left off right before the international break in a very good form, winning their last 3 away games for in La Liga, and out of their 6 last total games, they only managed to lose 1, winning the rest. The one they did lose to was to Real Madrid, which is very expected. Valladolid is coming into this game in a very, very good form. And again, this match will take place in El Camp Nou. Now, to transition onto the players to watch out for, again, I would have mentioned Orellana. However, Sean Weisman is actually their next top scorer, or tied with Orellana. So that is definitely gonna be the striker to watch out for. Now, in terms of how we should expect Valladolid to play, is to play actually pretty spread out. As soon as they get the ball, they're probably gonna play defensive for a good part of the game, but as soon as they get the ball spread out, they're gonna play very wide, a long ball over to the left side, and then just try to use pace and then look for a cross. That's how they tend to do their most of attacks. So with that being said, how is that gonna affect us? That's probably gonna mean that Sergino Dest, again, our right back, is most likely gonna have to stay a little bit further back, be a little bit more conservative on the type of attacks he makes, in order to be able to just absolutely neutralize their main form of attack. All right, so now when it comes to the formation that we're gonna play, now most likely we're gonna continue on to the theme of 3/5 in the back defenders. So in the goalkeeper position, it should be Ter Stegen, no doubts in my mind. In the left wing back position, it should be Jordi Alba. Lenglet spotting into the center back right next to Jordi Alba. Now, I'm actually thinking De Jong is gonna start as that middle center back with a lot of freedom to push up when he wants to. Why? Because he gives us a lot of ability to work out of the back. He gives us a lot of passing lanes from the back line, which has helped us tremendously. Mingueza next to him, and then Sergino Dest all the way in the right wing back position. Now, this is a little bit debatable because Araujo is fit to play, so at any moment, he could definitely either slot in for Mingueza or for De Jong, and then De Jong can push up to the midfield. But with that being said, I'm sticking with a 2-midfielder formation, and that being Pedri and Busquets. Pedri being a little bit more of the attacking-minded one, and Busquets obviously winning back balls and building up the play from there. Now, when it comes to our attack, I'm actually gonna opt for Dembele, Messi, and Griezmann up top. However, if Araujo does fit into that formation, then most likely it will be a 3-midfielder formation, and then one of the attackers will probably have to sit out for this game. But guys, like I mentioned, especially with the fact that Atletico Madrid just dropped 3 total points This is absolutely massive for Barcelona. Again, we're definitely going to be coming into this game with a lot of positive vibes. Sure, it might add a little bit of pressure onto us, but in the same boat, it takes pressure away. It's this weird feeling, but it definitely feels good to have La Liga in control. We're not necessarily like it doesn't mean we're going to win it for sure, but it's in our control, and that's a good feeling. Now, Real Madrid, the other contenders for La Liga, who currently are ahead of us in points, but that's because they do have a game in hand, do have to play Champions League. So that's a lot more minutes, a lot more miles onto their legs right before El Clásico, which is the next La Liga match day. So again, it's El Clásico sandwiched in between two very hard games for Real Madrid, which makes, I think, gives us a little bit of the upper hand when it comes to fitness, when it comes to maybe even possibly morale if Real Madrid does end up losing the first game. So guys, things are looking good. And for this game, I'm actually gonna go ahead and predict a 3-0 victory. I'm hoping Barcelona can continue on that form that we were on right before the break. That is one thing I do wanna mention. I don't want this break to kind of throw us off a little bit. Maybe the players that did end up playing with their national teams maybe kind of lose a little bit of the rhythm, a little bit of the scheme that Ronald Koeman had been building. So I'm definitely hoping, and this game has to be a preparation game for not only for Real Madrid to come, but again, we also have Atletico Madrid. But let's not forget La Copa del Rey final is also coming up very, very soon. So that's, you know, we do have a few things that we have to juggle through, but it is going to be crucial that we win this game, and that's where it starts off. Guys, you know the deal. Make sure you go down below. Tell me your score prediction. If you get it right, not only will you get yourself a shout out, but your name will go in the leaderboard for a chance to win yourself a Barcelona jersey. You're not going to want to miss out on that. If you're new to the channel, hit the subscribe button. We're going to be doing a lot of live reactions. And guys, I'm going to throw a little bit of a hint in there. We are allowed to stream again, so possibly for El Clásico, you should expect maybe a stream if you guys want to see it. Guys, if you enjoyed the video, hit a big, big, big thumbs up. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button and the notification bell on. Guys, as always, Visca Barça!